The trust started by accident. I went with two other Jesuit priests into the inner city to live back in the 1970s, and we went in to see if there was some contribution we could make, because the inner city of Dublin in those days was by far the most deprived area in the whole country. And the issue that became very relevant very quickly was the issue of young people leaving school early. They were leaving school at the age of 12. They were hanging around the streets all day long. Their parents were unemployed, couldn't give them any money. So they were doing a little bit of robbing. And by the time they got to 16 and 17, they were doing an awful lot of robbing and they were going to prison. So that was the problem we wanted to address. So we opened a youth club, we opened a craft centre. They could make various crafts, lovely crafts, which they were able to sell and make a few bob. We had employment schemes going where the young people were employed making the crafts, and we were selling them to the shops in town to pay their wages. And then I came across a 9-year-old kid sleeping on the street. So I said, well, we'd better do something for this group of young people. So we got a house and we opened it as a little hostel. And I thought no more of it, that we were just adding a hostel to the services for young people in that area that we already had. But then the numbers grew and grew, and the kids grew out of the hostel, got older, and so we ended up having to open a second hostel for the older age group, and then a third hostel, and then a fourth hostel. And then the drug problem hit Dublin, we opened our own drug detox centre. And then we had to get some more permanent accommodation, so we started getting a few flats, a few apartments together, where young people could live on a more permanent basis than in hostels. So one thing just led to another. There was no planning in this, I never planned. 5-year strategic plans I'd never heard of them in those days. So we just went from year to year and added on services as we felt that they were needed. Until more recently it became then the Peter McVerry Trust. And Pat Doyle took over as CEO of the trust, and it became a much more professionalised service.